Our topic here is a Verruca. You know this as being warts. And with your wart, you should be thinking about your virus, HPV. We have Verruca vulgaris, HPV2. You have Verruca plana, which is HPV 3 and 10. HPV1, such as Verruca plantar. And if it's condyloma, the one that you're also familiar with, condyloma acuminata, they're referring to your low strain of HPV 6 and 11. But let me show something to you in which you may or may not be familiar with, that all these HPVs that I'm showing you here are low strain. And each one of these HPVs are then giving you a different type of wart presentation. Verruca vulgaris, Verruca plana, Verruca plantar, and condyloma acuminata. The genital warts with higher risk of malignancy, of course, then referring to your HPV 16, 18, 31, 33. And the Verruca vulgaris, very common in kids. And the vulgaris is the one in which it's associated with HPV 2. And if it helps you, think about terrible twos. HPV 2 may result in Verruca vulgaris. Can be severe and recalcitrant and immunocompromised. Mean to say you're individuals who might have HIV or who are on immunosuppressant therapy may present with HPV that is not responding to medications, recalcitrant. Morphology, what are you going to find? Well, you know what warts look like. I'll show you a picture. Varies with location with HPV type. Here, for example, in the vaginal area, I'm showing you what's known as your HPV 6 and 11. These would be low strain type of HPV, and this then refers to as being your condyloma acuminata. Verruca. So morphology or pathology, what are we looking for? So obviously this is undergoing destruction. If anything, there is acanthotic epidermis. In other words, there's acanthosis. In addition, there's papillomatosis and hyperkeratosis. And here would be hypergranulosis in the epidermis. And this would be opposite, give me one condition that we've talked about, in dermatology in which the granule layer is actually absent or thinned out. And hopefully you'd tell me by reflex that this was psoriasis. But in this case, it's hypergranulosis, referring to your wart. Dilated and tortuous vessels in the dermis, obviously because of thickening taking place. Now, Verruca in children. Most warts will resolve with time. Treatment focused on your hastening resolution. And remember that destruction may be taking place. And so therefore, the areas that are you worried about would include some of your adherent areas. So podophyllin, or you have your cantharidin and LN2. Destruction taking place. Here, the drug or management that you want to know would be imiquimod cream approved for genital warts. Treatment can be problematic in immunocompromised patient, as we had referred to. And please keep in mind from microbiology that obviously here, with warts and HPV, and especially the higher strain and such, that you have vaccinations that are now available so that you can then combat some of the HPV, and of course, referring to your Gardasil. Differential diagnoses for Verruca. Well, wherever Verruca may be located, it might look like squamous cell cancer. However, in squamous cell cancer, there's going to be history of sun-exposed area, usually elderly individuals. And generally larger with squamous cell carcinoma, as I'll show you pictures of. And another important one is called a corn or clavus. And this occurs over the pressure area versus Verruca, not necessarily predisposed by pressure. It does not interrupt natural skin lines. In other words, referring to it as being your dermatogliping. And do not contain central thrombosed capillaries. Corn, clavus. Other differentials, as soon as you hear the term seborrheic keratosis, you should be thinking about that greasy yellow, maybe perhaps waxy type appearance. If it was an infant, then we refer to this being a cradle cap. And if it's condyloma lata, not to be confused with condyloma acuminata, which is the Verruca, lata would be referring to your secondary syphilis. And the condyloma lata, here the serologic test obviously would demonstrate the organism and maybe perhaps having positive for RPR for syphilis. Usually where you'd find this would be mostly in the areas that are moist, permucosal lesion, and this would be the lata. Make sure that you take a moment and you have already properly organized your lata as being part of your syphilis, or if you want, it'd be silly. I want a lot of syphilis, and not that anyone really wants that. Or you're accumulating from microbiology, your condyloma accumulating, acuminata, coelocytes, if that helps you. They're just quick little revisions of micro that you've looked at some point in time.